So originally this video was going to be about House, but oh boy, did that change. Toho decided to block the video worldwide, so that's great. So thanks a lot, Toho. Well, now we get to review an even better movie that I just saw recently. That will be Hereditary. Anyways, Hereditary is a really good movie, surprisingly. I did not like the trailers at all. I thought the trailers made it look horrible. It looked really terrible from the trailers. I know this is unpopular opinion, but I thought the trailers made it look like a jump scare fest, and those are really cheap to me, and I don't think horror should be that. And that's just, those trailers are horrible. What does those have to do with the rest of the movie? And like, they try to focus, the trailers focus mostly on the girl, but in the movie, the girl dies in the first 10 minutes, and the trailers just kind of like, I don't want to see this movie, because the trailers made out to be like this normal horror film that's like, not scary at all, it's just jump scares. But the movie was actually really good, surprisingly. Toni Collette was probably the best part of this movie. She really showed how much she can act through this movie. This movie would not have been the same if she was not in it, because she was excellent. She was probably the best I've seen her. I think this was better than her in The Sixth Sense, because she showed a lot of emotion in this movie. This movie was really creepy. It was super bizarre and uncanny. And some of the scenes were like, ugh, watching it in the theater a few years ago, which I saw it in theaters in Florida, and wow, that movie, I came out of theaters going, oh, what did I just watch? Because this movie was great. It was weird. It left so many things that were like, okay, what? Why is this happening? It's so weird. And it wasn't weird like House is. It was weird in a good way. Like, the plot made sense, but it was just felt wrong. Everything felt wrong, and that's a good thing if you're making horror, because that made me feel uncomfortable, and feeling uncomfortable is what you should feel when you're watching a horror film. And this film nailed it down perfectly. And all this stuff was like the weird like dollhouse shots where it was actually real. It was like, whoa, whoa, what the heck? And it's like the game night did the same thing. It looked fake, but it was real. And the sets that they had to have had for this movie, that seems like it'd be insane. In that house, is so cool looking. I love the look of that house. That is a great looking house. I've never seen anything like it. And the way that this lady copes with it is by making dollhouses. And the dollhouses are very realistic looking. And like when the girl dies, she makes the dollhouse version of it. And apparently this is her job. And the weirdest character in this movie is probably, I know, she turns out to be bad, but the lady, I think her name is like, Joanne. She was probably the weirdest character in this movie. I think she was weirder than the girl. She was very strange in this movie. And her character was really, it kind of showed like, you know how like there's that character that usually can kind of show the twist when it's gonna happen? This character was that person, but they did it way more subtly than other movies do it. Like, Us's reveal thing. This was way more subtle than Us's twist. And you really don't know that it was her that worked with the grandma until, like, I didn't realize it till like, literally the end of the movie. It was strange, and it was subtle, and I liked it. That is great filmmaking, especially in horror. And the little girl was great as well. She was creepy, and the makeup on her, sheesh, that's a lot of makeup. The teenager wasn't bad either. He was pretty good, but the one I felt was kind of weak in the acting was the dad, because he just showed, like, I didn't think he showed that much emotion in it when he was doing it, because, like, the dinner scene, oh my gosh, that's one of the best horror scenes I've ever seen. The dinner scene was so intense while watching it in theaters. It was insane. But it was just such a great movie. I've never seen anything like it. A24. Good job. A24 has always been doing good jobs with their horror movies. I'm excited to kind of see the newest one that they're about to release, directed by this man. This is like the most abnormal horror film, and the trailers made it look out to be the super normal horror film, like La Llorona. Like, this movie, I think, is going to be more remembered than something like La Llorona, because it's an actual horror film. It isn't just jump scares. And it's kind of sad. This movie was kind of blocked out when it first came out. It only barely made its budget back. Well, it made its budget back, but it didn't make it as much as, like, Us has. It only made around $80 million, with a $20 million budget, while something like Us, something that I thought was good, but it wasn't excellent like this movie was, one got like $300 million with the same budget. And it's just sad that movies like Annabelle, horrible horror film, can make be made for $1 million and make around like $500 million. That's insane. And it wasn't even good. Now, movies like this, when they come out, they're overlooked. This is a great horror film. I seriously recommend this movie. Go watch it. Watch it now. Ending is probably the worst part of the movie, but because it reveals too much, but everything else is great. The entire movie is atmospheric. It's well directed. The shots are beautiful. The acting is superb from Toni Collette, but sheesh, this is a terrifying movie. It makes you uncomfortable while watching it. I've never seen anything like it. This is very close, I'd say, to The Shining. This is amazing. Just amazing. And I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10.